I was a military brat, so I'm from just about everywhere. I was born in San Antonio, Texas, and spent the majority of my childhood in Birmingham, Alabama. I didn't always want to pursue research like a bunch of kids. I had no idea what I wanted to do when I was graduating high school. I just kind of came to college to figure things out, and really I kind of fell in love with it when I was here and started seeing some projects in the end phase and saw how it actually was going to affect people and the ways we can change things for the better.
Did you ever consider being a physician?
I have considered being a physician, and actually I'm currently, that is my career path. Hopefully when I finish this, I'll head off to medical school and have my MD, PhD, and be able to both practice and do research. My research is about intervertebral disc degeneration. So it's a common curse for all people. Everybody develops lower back pain, especially as you age, although a lot of different factors are involved, including, you know, your job, how much vibration or physical manipulations you experience, all kinds of things like that, genetics. But basically everybody is going to get it. Typically we spend somewhere in the neighborhood of $5 to $6 billion every year here in the United States alone treating lower back pain. Now, not all of that is caused by intervertebral disc degeneration, but a very large portion of it is associated with intervertebral disc degeneration. My research is focused mainly on trying to understand what exactly is happening there. And then once we have an idea of what's happening, how can we slow it, stop it? What kind of things are we doing in our normal daily lives that are harming it or causing more damage? Theoretically, if it all works out, we'll be able to cure intervertebral disc degeneration, which will decrease a lot of pain. And it's not just that it's painful. Some people literally have debilitating lower back pain where they cannot function. They literally become bedridden or things like that. So that would be a huge step, just the fact that we can cure it. If we never get to that level, at the very least, we can understand different mechanisms that we can do to decrease the pain or decrease the speed with which it happens. So it can help everyone from, you know, athletes who have lower back pain from or sport by finding different therapies that would be beneficial, to the elderly who just have the problem and different things they can do to potentially decrease their pain. I started here the summer of my first year here. They gave me kind of two different options. I could work on some of the cartilage stuff that Aaron was talking to you about earlier, or I could do this whole new branch that they were interested in looking in with the spine. And I was more interested in starting something brand new as opposed to jumping on to something that's already a little bit further down the pathway. So that's kind of where I got started, and I just kind of fell in love with the whole openness of this field.
Stannard also enjoys the dynamic among his colleagues.
We all collaborate on larger projects, and then we assist each other. We have journal clubs where we bring our ideas, and then we all critique the ideas and look at different papers and try to find the best next step, and just kind of a big collaborative family that we work in.
Stannard advises finding your own collaborative family.
Get involved. If you don't experience it, you'll never really know. There are labs all over campus, and pretty much every campus in the world that have lab space open for undergrads. It's not always the most glamorous of jobs. There'll be lots of time washing dishes and taking out trash and doing things that aren't that much fun. But all of those things are critical to giving you the opportunity to truly experience research and then learn if it is something that you are or are not passionate about.